welcome you all with my love and respects. First, let us understand the word Arogya Spurana. Health, of course, in Sanskrit, we have a different word for health. Swastha. Swastha means centered on yourself. The very definition of health in Sanskrit is totally different. Health is not diseaselessness. Please understand. Health is not just diseaselessness. It is a positive well-being, completely centered on yourself. Swastha means centered on your self, a different kind of positive well-being. Here, I am trying to express the whole spirituality centered on health, well-being, because you understand whether it is a meditation or spirituality or anything, based on what you feel inside your body. Please understand, as on now, all we have is only one thing, body. If we cannot handle this properly, if we do not handle this body properly, whatever we speak about meditation, spirituality, religion, everything is just dreams which churns the mind, that's all. As on now, you do not know anything more than body. For example, you say, I slept well. How? By remembering the feeling which you are having, which you had in the body. Which you had and which you are having. Only based on that feeling, you claim you slept well. Same way, oh, I felt in that meditation so peaceful, so blissful. How? Based on the feeling which you have inside the body, which you had or which you are having. So as on now, even your spirituality will be measured only based on the body. You do not know anything except body. All we know is only one thing, that is body. First thing we need to work is body. Then the meditation or spirituality, yoga or religion or God, Atman, Nirvana, anything can come. Everything can come later on. The first thing which we need to work, first thing which we need to understand is body, because all we have is only body. Usually, there are two kinds of maintenance in mechanical engineering. They say that breakdown maintenance and preventive maintenance. Whether you believe it or not, we are all doing only breakdown maintenance. We are all doing with as long as far as it is our body concerned. When it comes to our body, we are all doing only breakdown maintenance. As long as it runs, it runs. Neither we care about preventive maintenance, nor we learn about preventive maintenance. Here, these 2 days, I am going to completely concentrate on this preventive maintenance and breakdown maintenance. As on now, there are many people who are at the breakdown level, where maintenance is necessary. Not only necessary, it's an emergency. We will do the breakdown maintenance. Then, some more tips for preventive maintenance. Whole thing, this whole Arogya Spurana, is just these 2 words, preventive maintenance and breakdown maintenance. Straight away I am going to concentrate working on the body. Please understand, these 2 days you will not receive many concepts, theories, intellectual ideas. Usually all our meditation camps, at least there will be 1.5 hours, 2 hours lecture, then I present the meditation technique. But here, straight away I am going to work on the body. I will present the concept behind that meditation. Then we will enter into the meditation. Because I wanted you all straight away to have the benefit of meditation. Of course, all of you, you must have attended some program or other. I think seeing the faces who are all in the Gita. Maybe the whole batch was in the Gita. And the remaining are our own teachers. Anybody who has come outside the earlier, our own teachers and our own devotees. Yet, how many are seeing me first time? Please raise your hands. First time attending any of my program. Of course, the big problem is, even though we sit, we don't listen. If you listen, one lecture is more than enough. Basically, if you already heard or attended some programs, you know the basic concept of how the body and mind and being are connected intimately. Here, instead of trying to present concepts, I wanted 2 days to be completely spent on meditation techniques. Continuously working on yourself. These 2 days, I'm going to concentrate only on body, only on health. Then all the enlightenment, meditation, everything can come later on. Let all those things come later on. All those things are secondary. Please understand. You may think you are a great seeker, but you are seeking only well-being inside your being, inside your space. Be very clear, you do not know anything else except a peaceful feeling or a blissful feeling. That's all. Whenever that happens, you say you had a spiritual experience. So whatever you think as God, meditation, religion, spirituality, everything is nothing but peaceful or blissful feeling inside your being. As on now, we are not ease with ourselves. Some reason, I can say social conditioning or torturing yourself. In the initial level, society teaches you. After that, you yourself master the technique. Torture yourself. This goes on, till you completely destroy the body and mind. We continuously abuse the system. You have security alarm system for your house. You protect your house so much, in which hardly you spend 12 hours. Maximum in this country, you spend only 12 hours in the house. Even if you don't have work, somewhere you move around. Hardly 12 hours only people spend average in their house. For that, you have so much of protection mechanism, alarm system, and so much of cleaning and everything. But you reside in the body 24 hours continuously, but you don't have any alarm system. The only alarm system is pain. Pain is the only alarm system. But the problem is, when alarm system goes on, you work only to switch off the alarm. You don't enter into the house and see where the thief is. Why the alarm is ringing? We never go and find the root or the reason why the alarm is ringing. Why the pain is happening. All we try is put some painkiller and stop the pain. It's like you just switch off the alarm. That is not going to solve the problem. If you just switch off the alarm and next day when you go, nothing will be there. Please understand, we don't have any alarm system except pain. But whenever it comes, first thing we resist the pain. We do not understand the message delivered to us through pain. Whenever pain happens to you, there is a message for you. It is just alarm. Look into the message. What exactly the pain is trying to convey? What exactly the pain wants to tell me? What exactly I need to learn from the pain? Same way, continuously our body is giving so many messages for us. According to Ayurveda, not only according to Ayurveda, according to the truth, human body is the most sophisticated intelligent system in the whole planet Earth. If you see two, three things, first thing, converting bread into blood, which every day your body does. People come and ask me, Swamiji, why don't you do some miracles? Why don't you show us some miracles? Why don't you convert water into wine? Converting water into wine, breweries do. You don't need to be God for that. Converting water into wine is a great spiritual quality. That's what all the breweries are doing. Converting man into divine is the real thing. Not converting water into wine. Anyhow, I always tell them, your body, see the miracles done by your body. Every day the bread is becoming blood. Whatever you add into your system, that becomes part of your system. If we have to do this mechanically, converting bread into blood, if you have to do it mechanically, we need an industry which runs 3 miles length. Scientists say 3 miles length the industry will run. If we have to do that mechanically, the outside. And if we have to do one information processing, means receiving one data from the world, processing it and giving the answer. For that, you need a computer which will be 3-story height. If we have to do that, for example, now you are seeing me. This scene goes inside and you process it. First you do that neti-neti process. This is not, this is not, this is not a tree, this is not a animal, this is not this, this is not this. You do the excluding process. Then you start identifying, this is it, this is it, this is it. Then all your past memory comes, your past memory with me. Then you decide, sit here, listen attentively. For this simple process to happen, you store so much of data, so much of information. If we have to do this mechanically, we need a computer which will be 3-story height. People come and ask me, Swamiji, my mind is too noisy. I wanted to silence my mind. I wanted to experience silence. I tell them, never say. For the amount of work which your mind does, your mind is not too noisy. It is completely silent. The amount of work which goes on, for that surely it is silent. Now, please understand the miracles happening inside your system continuously. So much is happening inside you, we never look into that. Because we never look into it. First thing, we take our body for granted. Next thing, start abusing it. Whenever you take something for granted, you start abusing it. The moment you take your relationship for granted, you will start abusing. The moment you take your house or some product for granted, you will start abusing it. We will start abusing the moment we start taking things for granted. You don't understand. The body completely, how much is happening. And moreover, these people, I have seen many times, these people who do whatever they want, finally they come and tell me, especially the so-called traditional Vedantis, they always come and complain to me, Swamiji, because of body, I am destroyed, because of my senses, all my life is wasted. They read some, here and there, some books and start abusing the senses. They continuously complain. No. My whole spiritual life is spoiled because of my senses, Swamiji. Because of my senses only, my whole life is spoiled. Please be very clear. Your senses are not spoiling your being. You are spoiling your senses. You have a deep desire. Your senses are cooperating, just helping you. You have a deep desire to go and drink. Your legs are helping you. What to do? Through the legs, you go to the bar and abuse your system. And then come and tell me, because of your senses, you are losing all the spirituality. Please be very clear. It is not our senses which is abusing us. We who are abusing our senses. We who are abusing our body. Whatever we want, we use. Whatever way we want to enjoy, we use our body for that. We abuse our body. Then, we blame the body finally. Anyhow, whether you blame the body or not, who is going to suffer? You are going to suffer. Now, instead of doing this blaming game, he is the reason. See after that, Katrina? Each one is blaming one person. See, these guys can do the blame game later on. But who are suffering? So now, we don't have time to do the blaming game. Blaming this person, blaming that person. Let us find out the root and start healing it. Let us find out the root and start healing it. Never abuse the senses. Never abuse the body. Never disrespect the temple in which you are staying. First thing, we don't have respect for ourselves. That is why we go on disrespecting the body. If you have respect for yourself, you know you are staying in this body. Naturally, you will start respecting it. I have expressed so many thoughts, so many ideas to maintain the body and the mind with a deep easiness, the deep connected feeling. Now, of course, I have expressed this in a different places, in different discourses, different camps, different ways. Now I am trying to collect all the thoughts and present it in one form, in one set, only based on the physical health, giving, meditation, yoga, pranayama, whatever. We have so many different abilities of our being. One, we can change the energy through the breathing. Next, we can change the energy through visualizations. We can change the energy through kriyas. We can change the energy through meditation. We can change the energy through verbalization. I am using all these things. Above all, the energy of consciousness. Whole thing just to make you healthy. These 2 days, please do not ask any question which is not related to health. Put questions only which is related to health. Let us first work on the body. If you are here for anything else except health, I think you are in the wrong place. At least for next 2 days. If you want meditation, if you want enlightenment, come for NSP. That is the place for all the meditation, all the spiritual experience, everything. But here, these 2 days, straight away I am going to work on body. Because first thing which we need to do is body. Actually, I should have started this program 3 years ago when I started the movement. But to tell you honestly, people are not ready to sit 2 days for their body's sake. If you give them some promise, God will jump on your head. Some gold coins will be showered on your head. And you will have dabu dabu. Then they are ready to sit for even 1 month. But if I tell you will feel healthy, you will be okay. No, already I am healthy. What is there? Especially these Indians. Indians don't have health consciousness at all. Completely, once it breaks down, only then they even look at the body. Only then they look at the body. Body is the last thing in their laundry list. In their laundry list, body is the last thing. Anyhow, at least now, let us work on the body. Let us work on the preventive maintenance and breakdown maintenance. First thing, let's all introduce ourselves to each other so that you will feel comfortable. These are all few basic things. The introducing is a basic thing. Otherwise, you will always feel uncomfortable. You will always feel like you are somewhere in a new place. Actually, all these phobias, especially this claustrophobia and all, is not even related to space or closed space. It is related to feeling uncomfortable. When you don't feel comfortable with the next person, even if there is enough space, you will feel you are inside a cave. If you feel comfortable with the other person, you want to have a cave. You will not ask for bigger space. You will ask for smaller space. So now, first thing, please take few minutes. I'll also be here. All of you go around. Just take 10 minutes, 10-15 minutes. Introduce yourself to all the new people. Spend 2-3 minutes. And just few things. Name, you are from where? One or two words. Please do not start your history. When I was in the army. You will not, 10 minutes will not be sufficient. I will not be able to start the subject. Because I wanted to enter into the subject immediately. Before entering into the subject, let you all feel comfortable. First thing, we are going to work. Before that, I should tell the honest truth. Of course, by most of you know me, so I can tell the truth. Somebody asked me, what Arogya Spurana is, what you are going to speak on, what it's all about. I said, who knows? Who knows? I can tell one thing. Please take few minutes and in your notebook, write a list of pains, uneasiness or diseases which you are having. Pains. Please understand. Three level. Pains, superficial, irritations like a ulcer or wheezing, that type of things. Third, diseases. These three level, all three level, please write whatever you have. Even if you suspect the little or the slight symptoms you are having, please write it down. It's for yourself, you are not going to show it to anybody. Even I am not going to read, so you can write clearly. And it's for yourself. And keep it safely with you so that the next person doesn't read. Don't copy from the next person. Don't show it to that person and don't copy from the next person. Indian schools, the copying is a big problem. These kids, without even knowing what they are copying, they copy. Once really it happened, one of my classmates was sitting and copying me. Whatever I am writing, simply the teacher caught hold of him when he corrected the paper. Because the question is, what is your name? He simply wrote what I wrote. So, please don't copy. Yes. Please understand, you already attended some of our programs, or you already know me, you may be knowing. Whenever I make any statement, I take responsibility for that statement. Now I tell you, even though it feels too good to be true, I tell you, whatever you have written will disappear. You may think, what are you talking so much? Please understand, whatever you think as disease, whatever you names you may give, pain, disease, irritations, uneasiness, everything has got only 2-3 roots. Just 2-3 roots in your system. Because we do not go and touch the root, because we do not handle the root properly, we continue to struggle and suffer. I am giving you this statement, and not only that, when I say, I take the responsibility of that statement. I take the responsibility of that statement. All I request is, just try to put your best or your maximum energy into this meditation, maximum effort into this meditation, and just few tips which I am giving, try to imbibe in your life, nothing else. Please understand, just two things. These 2 days, maximum whatever you can, put your effort in the meditation techniques, and these few tips which I am giving, imbibe them in your life. The whole program is just based on health. Please understand, I am not teaching any morality, I am not teaching any spirituality, I am not giving you any experience of spiritual things, I am not asking anything, I am not going to talk anything about spirituality. We are going to straight away work on your body. That is the reason. When somebody asks me, what are you going to talk in the Arogya Spurana Swamiji? I said, who knows? Because I am not going to give you any theories. And to tell you honestly, I don't believe in theories. I don't believe in talking. I don't believe in words. But straight away, if I ask you to meditate, you people will ask so many thousands of doubts. Just to convince you logically, I speak few words before the meditation. Tell you honestly, I hate to speak. Give just theories and words. Let us work on the body. Let us do something. Vivekananda says beautifully, if you can imbibe just 5 concepts in your life, that is 10 times better than reading the whole library. There is no need to read the whole library. Just bring it to the, just let us work. Work on the body, work on the mind. Even for spirituality, working on the meditation only will work. That only will help. I always tell people, your work will speak for you. Your speaking will never work for you. Your working will speak for you automatically. Here, first thing, we are going to work on our body to remove the unnecessary toxins. I have to use the word toxins because I don't know any other word. In Sanskrit, we call them dosha. In English, I don't know any other equivalent word. Basically, the dosha is because of the imbalance of vada, pitta and kapha. These 3 energies. Alright, I'll just give the meaning. Please understand the concept. Understand the concept, then you'll be able to understand. Because there is no exact translation. It's all the words I am using are from Ayurveda system. The exact translation words are not there. Even the Ayurvedic books, English books, they use the same word only. They just give the meaning and they use the same word. All these 3 are responsible for our body functioning in a balanced way. Same way, all these 3 are only responsible for all our diseases. When we work on these 3, whatever we have inside the body, it can be completely healed. One more thing, when we work on the vada and pitta and kapha, even your bone structure will start healing itself. If somebody has got bone problems, even that will start healing itself. Because bone also is continuously created our body. Don't think you have the same bone structure. Continuously body is healing itself. Continuously body is altering itself. Continuously body is doing the repairing work. Because it is intelligence. As I was telling you, our body, human body, is the most intelligent system in the whole planet Earth. The amount of work which is happening inside, if you see, it is equivalent to the amount of work which is happening in the cosmos. That's why they say macrocosm and microcosm. Macrocosm is this universe. Microcosm is this body. Brahmanda and Pindanda. In Ayurveda, we call the body as Pindanda. Pindanda means the universe in miniature form. It is not just the body. It is the universe in miniature form. This universe in the miniature form. So please understand, we are going to work on the microcosm, which is intelligence. First thing we need to understand, we need to realize your body is intelligence. It is not dead as you think. It is not just biomechanism as you believe. It is living intelligence. It responds to your thoughts. It responds to your thoughts. A simple experiment. If you close your eyes and remember your enemy. Enemy means person who gave you money and asking back. To whom you gave money who is not giving back. Just remember that person. Within 2-3 minutes the BP will increase. BP will increase. And the pulse rate will change. Your whole temperature will be different. Means what? Your body responds to your thoughts. Your body responds to your thoughts. Same way, any scene or body which awakens fantasy, immediately the body temperature is different. Immediately your body is different. Please be very clear. Your body responds to your thoughts. If you are frightened, if you are suffering out of any fear, if you have a fear stroke, immediately you can see your body temperature is different. Your body continuously responds to your thoughts. It is pure intelligence. Here, we are going to work on the Vada, Pitta and Kapha. The toxins which we are having inside our system. And one more request, again I tell you, if you want to experience meditation or if you want to experience the spirituality of God, do NSP or Atma Spurana, Healers Initiation, those programs. Here, purely health, and ask only questions related to health. You can put any questions related to your health, or if you want to ask for healing, let's work only on body. First thing, now we are going to work on removing the toxins from the body. It's a meditation. I cannot call this as a meditation. I can say it's a kriya, because the word meditation has got a different meaning. These are all kriyas to awaken the energies of your body, to clean the body. I can say it's one of the important kriya from Ayurveda system. It's a 30 minutes kriya. First thing, of course, if you are dentist training, you might have done it. It's related to the bioenergy. First thing, you will continuously shake the whole body. First 10 minutes. Second 10 minutes, of course, it's very funny. If you have done our LBP, you know the Manipuraka meditation, catharsis. Here again, I'm using the catharsis to clear the pitta. See, there are all the three energies. All three energies will be balanced by these three steps. first 10 minutes, I wanted you to completely shake the body. If you have, have you seen the Parkinson's people? How they shiver. Like that, now consciously shake. If you don't do consciously, body will start doing after some time. There's so much of toxins added. What will it do? It will start doing by itself. Now let us clear everything. Now let us clear everything. These are some kriyas to clear the body, to clear the toxins. First thing, 10 minutes, shake. Completely shake the whole body. Don't allow even a single net energy center to rest. According to Ayurveda, we have 74,000 energy center in our body. 10,000 is in the head. 74 in the body. And you'll be surprised, only 13,000 you use from your birth to death. From your birth to death, you use only 13,000. All other energy centers, they take VRS before, without even joining the duty. They just take VRS without even joining the duty. They never come to life. You never use them. Now, you are working to awaken them. First thing, 10 minutes, completely, wild way, shake your whole body. Your hands, legs, neck, the whole body. As wildly as possible. Let it be completely, let it become like a liquid. I'm just making your whole body as a liquid. As on now, it is solid, just tensed like a stone. That is why you will never allow the energy flow. That is why you never allow the self-healing effect to happen in your system. Whatever prints are there, just you hold them. You just hold them. You never let the breeze in. Here, by shaking the whole thing, your whole body will become like a liquid. Don't be afraid. These are all foolproof, solid techniques. Anybody having heart problem? Only people who are having heart problem. Those people don't do. I'll give you a little altered technique. For how many? Only one? Please raise your hand. Yes, you people will not do this meditation and others can do. Just shake the whole body, neck, head. Do not allow even a single energy center to rest. Just for 10 minutes in a wild way. The next 10 minutes, if you have done LVP, you know the manipura, the catharsis. Just create whatever sound comes in your mind. Just create whatever sound comes in your mind. You may think, what is this, Swamiji? You will look like a mad. Please understand, if you don't become mad now, you will be mad in the house regularly. Continuously you are vomiting on others. But don't you see? The irritation which you are carrying inside only, you are vomiting on others. Even for small things you shout. Even for small things, you shout. You wait people to do mistake so that you can relax. You can just catharsis. You can just feel little empty. You are just overflowing with irritation. You just wait. A small sound is enough. The sound which you create will be 10 times worse than that small sound. Child, if he drops a tumbler, that is one small sound. But sound which you create, have you no sense? What are you doing? You will be creating 10 times more sound. Wife, when she keeps a coffee cup, a small sound enough. Have you brought from your father's home? Then she will start. The job which you are doing, coffee itself is too much. Keep quiet and drink. And then the whole thing, whole drama starts. After that, you know what usually happens. Anyhow, we are just overflowing with irritation. We are just filled with irritation. That is why we don't feel comfortable wherever we go. Whether it is some party or house or office, continuously sitting and watching like a supervisor. Long face. The Buddha. No, really, that's what we are doing. Please understand, that is what we are doing. Because we don't feel comfortable with anything. Wherever we go, we just continuously try to protect ourselves. Should I be here? Should I not be here? What am I doing? These things are going well? Or am I maintaining my status? Continuously, you are bothered. That actually, you do not know the amount of irritation which you create inside you by continuously protecting your so-called status or prestige. Please try to relax. At least now. Of course, after day, from Monday onwards, you do whatever you want. Now if you can relax, it will be easy for you to get healed. It will be easy for you to remove the vada pitta kapha inside you. And please be very clear, vada pitta kapha, all the three are directly related to your mind. Your pitta is directly related to visualization. Vada is directly related to verbalization. And kapha is related to consciousness. That is why if the pitta becomes too much, your visualization will be imbalanced. See, people who can't think, can't visualize things properly, naturally we tell them, I think the pitta has gone to head. That is why he is not able to visualize. When you drink, why do you see 2-3 forms?
Yes.
Because the pitta is imbalanced. If you drink too much, you start seeing 2-3 forms. You start seeing so many things. A small story. One guy goes to the hospital with his friend. The friend is fully drunk and is lying. He goes to the doctor with his friend. This guy, both are drunk. And this fellow a little too much, so he's flat. Doctor comes and he does the first aid. The doctor asks the guy who's lying, hey, what's happening to you? What's your name? This guy tells his name. My name. Something. Then he asks, are you seeing animals all over the room? Are you seeing different figures all over the room? Are you seeing some ghost? This guy says, no, I am not seeing anything. I am perfectly all right. I am not seeing anything except you. Then the doctor says, oh, no problem. Then you are all right. By tomorrow morning, you will become all right. But the friend says, doctor, please do something. You know, I know, room is filled with animals. All ghosts are here. He is not able to see even these things. Please do something and let him be healed. You also know, I also know, room is filled with all the animals. So this guy is seeing all those things. Actually, when your pitta is imbalanced, your visualization is imbalanced. Your visualization is imbalanced. Your clarity of thinking is imbalanced. Whenever you carry the irritation, same way you imbalance your pitta. You imbalance your pitta. Now, throw away all the negativity which you are carrying. Empty all the irritation which you are carrying. Let it come out in the form of shouting or crying or screaming. Don't bother, we have soundproof, soundproof system. Don't bother, just bring that out. Let everything come out. After that, last 10 minutes, sit silently. Sit silently. Let me explain once more. First 10 minutes, shake the whole body. Shake the whole body so that your body will become liquid. Next 10 minutes, let all the irritation come out. Third 10 minutes, sit silently and witness whatever is happening in the body and in your mind. It's an initial preparation technique. I'm preparing you, tuning the body to enter into the deeper level things. I wanted at least all of you to do 15 meditation techniques in these 2 days. At least 15 meditation techniques. I'm not going to speak much. Working on you, you will achieve something. Whatever it is. Can you get something just by words? We can't get, you can't get mango out of mantra. Use any mantra. Can you get one mango? Nothing. It will come only by working. Let's work on our self. I wanted all of you to do at least 15 meditation techniques. It depends on you only. We will be able to finish. Now, any doubt in the instruction? Yes.
Do we keep sitting?
No. First two steps you will stand. Last step you will sit. No sitting in the chair. Last step you can sit. Try your best to sit in the ground. If you can't sit in the ground, then sit in the chair. Any doubt in the instruction? Okay.